Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Eason's, can I take the opportunity to welcome you to the Europa Hotel tonight for this very special evening with Stephen Ferris.
Mr. Stephen Ferris.
So thank you very, very much to everybody who turned up here tonight. It means a lot. Friends, family, fans, it shows how much respect you have for me as a player, and hopefully when you read my book you'll have even more respect for me.
Why did you take the title Man and Ball? What's the story behind it?
I think that last clip summed it up. I tackled man and ball as much as I could. It was kind of my trademark as a player, and it just seemed right. We chatted about a few other ones, and there was one Eason Ferris come up, but I don't think that would have sat well with everybody. So we went for man and ball, and it's funny. We're chatting. Rory McIlroy obviously done the foreword for me, and he sent me a picture of the front of the cover. Instead of man and ball, it said beast and ball. I think I might have been a contender as well.
Yeah, you mentioned Rory McIlroy, a good friend of yours. How proud were you that he wrote the forward to this book?
Yeah, look, listen, Rory's an absolute gentleman. When I asked him would he write the forward for me, his response was, yeah, no problem, I asked him to help me out. And it took a while to get the hold of him, actually. It took a couple of weeks. But Patrick McCarry, my ghostwriter, he chatted to him on the phone and said he was absolutely fantastic. And any question that Patrick set out for him, he answered it. He's a great guy. He's brilliant for Northern Ireland. He's a friend of mine, and very honoured and privileged to have his name in the front of the book as well.
Yeah, to have somebody who's one of the most recognisable sportsmen in the world at the moment to actually contribute to your book is pretty special.
It is, yeah, it is. I said to Roy, I was like, if you need anybody to write the foreword for your book, My Ulster highlight was, it's more or less been a journey that I've been on with Ulster from 2005 to 2014. The progression in professionalism, the teammates that you see come and go, coaches that you see come and go, but where the actual team is now and where it was when I first joined. I know we won the league in 2005, 2006, but that was a bloody fluke. we didn't have the team back then to compete. And just the rise of Ulster Rugby, and I just hope that we can stay there for the next 10 years. Ulster Rugby was everything to me and has been, and get emotional talking about it. It was a good place.
Mm. What do you miss the most about it?
Right, Winker, stop these questions, like, will you? What do you miss the most?
I'm not turning them back to them, like. I just saw you.
I missed the crowd.
I saw you getting a bit emotional, I thought you went for a joke there.
Yeah. Well, like, it's not like, I miss the crack, I miss the laughs, I miss, that's why I play a good bit of golf, I like getting out on the golf course, having a bit of crack. You miss being in the gym, turning on with dance music and the coach is coming down from upstairs telling you to turn it down, and like, piss it off, and it's just the laugh, like, just the change room, you miss the change room, like, and it was just time to come to an end, but I say to everybody, you have to retire at some stage. I just had to retire a few years earlier than everybody else, but you do miss the crack, you miss the laughs. And I even was playing golf with Gilly and Trimby and a couple of the other lads there on Monday, and Marcy and Trimby and Gilly, and just the laugh, having a good crack for a couple of days, it's brilliant, it brings back memories as well for me, socializing with those boys.
I think that's why everyone here had a real affinity with you when you were playing for Ulster, because as you can see, it still does, it still really meant an awful lot to you.